91, Channel 16, over.
U.S. Coast Guard, U.S. Coast Guard, this is fishing vessel Starlight. Looks like I have an entangled whale out here. I'm just curious what you need me to do.
When we get the call, our highest priority is to get back in touch with the person who observed the entanglement and to find out everything we can about it. In effect, we make them a part of the team at that moment. The Disentanglement Network is really made up of a lot of people filling a lot of different roles.
There are the disentanglers themselves. These are the experts, the people that are trained and have experience in cutting large whales free. And then there's a support team, first responders.
A first responder can be anybody and everybody in and around the ocean or the coastline, somebody on shore, on a boat in the water. It really can be anybody.
But a lot of reports come from the professional mariners out there. These are the fishermen, the tour boat industry, especially the whale watch captain.
Try to get a closer look with binoculars. Hopefully the crew can get some good photos that we could zoom in on and get some good solid information to the entanglement response team.
The size of the animal, the age class, the body condition, the extent of the entanglement, and that allows us to prepare properly.
The information that we get from the people who report is critical in determining the successful outcome of the response.
It's extremely important to have a team or make this a team effort. Nobody could do this on their own.
You would think it'd be easy to spot an entangled large whale. I mean, again, a whale that's 40 feet long, 40 tons in weight, dragging maybe a red buoy behind it. And yet, it's not. If someone doesn't stay with the animal or doesn't give us good detailed information of which way it was going, what speed, we typically do not find that whale again.
Oh, there we go. All right, let's get that throwing grapple ready.
One of the first things we do when disentangling a whale is establish a control line or get a working line into the animals. And then from that, we attempt to slow the whale down or tire it out so it stays at the surface so we have enough time to work on it.
What do you go for, David?
Give me a little bit of forward speed. Whale's diving. All right, whale's pulling.
Yeah, go.
Okay, they got it successfully hooked on underneath the floats.
When you come up alongside or behind a whale, if the size itself doesn't impress you, just when they surface and that tremendous exhalation of air blasts, that puts a punctuation on the size and gives you just a small indication of the massive power of this animal.
We're not trying to overpower them. No way are you going to do that. We're just trying to rein them in a little bit, maybe, by using a technique that's going to slow them down and give us the ability to pull up to the animal, do some more assessment, and then perhaps cut the animal free.
So see, they're right up alongside the whale now.
Her mouth is clean. I don't see anything.
One moment, it might be very complacent, just lying there. But you make one cut, and as lines shift and there's pain and there's the sense that maybe the whale's getting free, things can suddenly change.
Okay, let's go.
Everything that we do, right down to making that final cut, is very carefully calculated. And we have developed the tools that we think in most instances can make each of those actions work as safely and efficiently and quickly as possible.
Attempting to cut now, it looks like.
You got it.
Our response to an entangled whale is not just to help that one whale. It is really a conservation effort to try to prevent whales in the future from being entangled. And so everything that we do and everything that the public does to help with this effort is really helping not just that one animal, but helping the whole species and maybe even several species of large whale down the road. We've learned a lot over the years from all of the disentangling we've done and the documentation of the gear and the whales, but there's so much more to learn before we reach that ultimate goal of prevention. And that's why it's so really essentially important for everyone on the water, if they see an entangled whale, to do the best they can at documenting that, because that simple act of documenting it well will add more information that feeds into the ultimate goal of prevention.